So for these back tree trunks, what I'm going to do there is, let's go back to the palette again. Again, I'll take my burnt umber, and I'm going to add a little bit of water to it. Same as what we did for the real back trees, but this time I'm not going to use quite as much water. And that'll also help me just get it transparent. So, see, there's a little bit of white there. A little bit of a sky color that was lying there. You can bring that in too if you want to, if you're painting in oils. That's fine. Doesn't matter. All we're trying to do is just ensure that our color is not too intense too quickly. Otherwise, we're not going to get that lovely distance. So let's pop him in. Now, when you get here to the bottom of the tree, remember he sort of disappears into the snow. So you can leave this little area soft. So you can even just tap it with your finger, just to make sure you don't get a hard edge over there. It's easy for us to come back in and make a hard edge again. But it's not always that easy to lose a hard edge. So by the same token, you can sort of take it down a little bit further than what you need, so that when you do paint your snow over it, your tree trunk will sort of grow out of the snow. There's an interesting one there, and I think I'd like to have another extra dude over there. And let's see. So here and there I'll maybe make a decision to add something in that I didn't draw in. No, that's fine. Because I'm only using this picture as my guide, I can do that. So you can see, just by putting them in, we're already starting to get a feel of the distance. Alright, so we need to add a little bit of contrast to that. So I'm going to add a little bit of detail to that. So I'm going to take this color that I've been using and add just a little bit more of the burnt umber to it. Now guys, again, if you haven't got burnt umber, then say use raw umber and some ultramarine. If you haven't got any dark brown like that, then maybe use your alizarin crimson and ultramarine. Add mix them together and pop it into the orange. Remember, brown is orange's shadow color. Alright, so now to get that sort of tree barky effect, I'm going to take the brush and I'm going to hold it upright like this, and I'm going to tap it very randomly. Tap it. And at the moment, you're not going to see it as well as you'd want to, because there's not much contrast there. But later on, I think I'm actually going to take a little bit more of this red sky color into there, just to get him a little bit grayer than what he is now. To dry that guy now. When we come to the front trees, you'll really see this bark technique nicely, and you'll see how effective yet easy it is. It's peanuts. Guys, all I'm trying to do is just give myself an impression of the contrasts, or the impression of the detail, by using very low contrast. Don't go too contrasty yet. And as I tap, when I've got a big tree like this, as I tap, as I go across, I use less and less tap, so more and more distance in between them. And that makes them sort of break up. And you can already start to see that it already looks round. I haven't even added a highlight or nothing in there yet. Alright, actually, I think what I'll do for a highlight, let's maybe take say some of this color that we've got here, and let's add say a touch of orange to it. So let's get some orange in there. Orange in there like that, and we push it back with some sky color to get our atmospheric perspective correct. And maybe even just a tiny touch of yellow just for a bit of sunlight. Why not? Okay, so I'm going to just dab in some of these guys over here. See how quick it goes. I'm not trying to do all sorts of fancy things at this point. Really not necessary. Yeah, that's good enough. If we, as we come closer, if we see we haven't got enough contrast, we can always increase the contrast there. It's not a problem. Okay, so let's start getting our snow effect. So now I'm going to take, I've got my shadow color for the snow, but now I need a highlight color for the snow. So let's see, what are we done with? We're done with him. We're done with him, all these little greens in the background. So I think let's dump that, and that'll give us some space. So we can use some titanium white. Let's pop that down over there. And a speck of yellow in it. Not too much, just a speck. Even that's way too much. I want it just off-white. That's happened to you, just hang on to that, don't throw it away. Cool, man, let's go and paint some snow. Alright, so what we're going to work on now is sort of this area over here. So I'm going to zoom in a little bit more so you can see the area that I'm working on better while I've got it small like that. So I'm not going to try and get it perfect. So I'm picking up some of this little highlight sun color of ours. And now I'm going to look for those sunny bits. So I know I've got some snow lying up against this tree over there. So I'll start there, and I'll make him overlap that tree there like that. So I'll pop him down over there, and drag him out, and fade him away. Remember, no hard lines. The only hard lines you're going to still see is at the top area over there. Maybe here, I've got a few little dabs. So as you can see, sometimes when I'm painting here at this point, you can hardly even see it because we've got such low contrast. We haven't got lovely contrasts to work with yet, and that's fine. That's exactly the way it's supposed to be. So don't panic if You think, oh, I can't even see what I'm doing. Yeah, that's just the way it is. You're hardly going to see what you're doing. So working a little bit more on that. So again, I'm just dabbing and dashing. If I see I get a hard line, just fade him away. What you can also do is, as you go along, let's get the palette there. So I've been using this, and as I go along, I'd maybe pick up a little bit of my snow shadow color, and just mix a little color, and pop it in. For example, here on this side, I need a shadow, so I'll quickly mix up that little shadow there. That's fine. There's a dent. So what's going to happen is in the pieces that are high lying, you can say sort of the high lying snow that catch the sun, you can use the sun color. The minute you've got a dent or something that's pointing away from the sunlight, then you're going to get a shadow. Then you're going to use the shadow colors. I will be showing you how to do like footsteps and stuff later, then that will sort of make a little bit more sense. Okay, I think I'm happy with that, so let's move on to here in the background. Again, there's not too much going on here, so I'm just going to add a little bit of sun and stuff, and a few little contrasts. So it's mostly, I would say, horizontal lines that I'm doing now. But I'm softening those lines as I go along. So then it's my battle a little bit to keep up, because I've got such tiny little areas that I need to paint at this point. So there's no, aren't any real nice big areas for him to zoom in on and stay zoomed in. If you get like those shadows too big at this point, doesn't matter, it's all good. Dabs and dashes, if I have to go over the tree, that's also fine. It's more important to get that continuity. Guys, I just want to do one thing. This, I bought a new white, but it's not a decent opaque white, so I'm gonna dump that and just mix up a new white. It's got no covering power. Let's use this white. Always rely on our white to be opaque to give us that covering power. Let's get that in there. Send that extra one side and work it more white, and that gives us that nice little just off white. Great. Let's try again. Oh yeah, there we go, that's better. Now I'm getting sunlight. I think let's bring this tree maybe a little further down. Cool, now that I've put that guy, extended him, I can add a nice little shadow to him, and that's going to help give me extra perspective there. Yeah, he stands out nicely there. Yeah, maybe just a touch darker. Like that. So as I put him down, I just go and soften out those edges there. Let's get some nice sunlight on that side to really accentuate that shadow colour over there. I think over here we can pop in a few more little shadows. A little dense. What all these different tonal values are that you're sort of just scrubbing in here now is, it shows you the undulations. In other words, if we go to here, it gives you these little humps and bumps going up and down and up and down like that. That's what we're busy doing at the moment. It's just getting that. You can sort of say the contouring. That's what we're doing now. But because it's far away, I can't go into heavy detail and stuff. Alright, let's get some nice sunlight shining through this between that tree and that tree there. So again, I'm working right up against that shadow. I want to get that shadow soft edged. What you can even do is put down a line. Let's say you put down a line like this. Then you can use a clean dry brush and just soften the edges like that. That will also help you. So if you do use this soft dry brush, then what you're going to do is, as you've softened out your edge, then immediately just wipe it on your cloth, and that'll stop it from getting dirty and eventually full of paint. So I think I'm going to start darkening this guy up. So now we can start painting these front ones. So now we're at the front already.